Hello everyone, I hope you're all having a fabulous day. I'm not too sure when you're going to see this, but I promised you that I would show you how I pack my Luxe goodies for my travels in my carry-on and in my large suitcase, and that's exactly what I'm going to do. So I think I'm gonna turn the camera around because it might be a little bit easier so you have an idea as to how much I'm bringing back and how I'm going to set everything up. So hopefully, fingers crossed, this ends up working out. Okay, so I flipped the camera around so you can see, or so you have a better idea as to what I'm bringing back to the States from London. I have a Primark bag, a Liberty bag, two Louis Vuitton bags, a Chanel, Longchamp, and a Selfridges bag. And this is my luggage. So I have my carry-on. This suitcase has to be checked in. As you can see, my niece BB, and then I have a pair of shoes and then some souvenir shirts. Now, originally I was going to bring my Keepall 45 bandolier, but I saw that the flight was it was packed on the way here, and I also saw that it was packed on the way home, and I just didn't want to run the risk of having to check in my Keepall 45 bandolier for whatever reason. Let's say something happened. I didn't want to run the risk of having such a soft-sided luggage, having it be checked in that way. If I had to, for whatever reason, I have this. It has a hard shell, and it's a lot. It just seemed the safer choice to go for. So I was very sad that I couldn't bring my Keepall, but I digress. Okay, so here is the main setup. We will see how this works. I consider myself to be pretty good at Tetris, so we will get it all done. So we will have all these shopping bags. I'm taking all the shopping bags. I'm taking all the boxes and all the goodies as well. Okay, so the souvenir shirts that I said, I have a pair of shoes here. I will be wearing my boots. I already have a pair of heels that I wore for the Ritz, and then I also have some flats. This bag here is my dirty clothing that I wore for the week. I always put it in another little bag. And over here I have my trench coat, and I have a couple other shirts that I didn't wear. So as you can see, I have quite a bit of space. So how exactly am I going to fit this in? All right, so since I wore my sneakers here, my boots I'm gonna wear out, so it gives me a lot more room. These guys I can just kind of fit in here since they are flats. I could just do this, easy peasy. All right, this was a gift wrap that I got at Primark. So this guy will just go in here, not a big deal. Now, as far as the niece BB, a lot of you were asking me when I did my what's in my bag, my travel edition. This is pretty much empty. I have a few other goodies in here. The other toiletries that I either use very, very few. If I use a little bit of toiletries or whatever I have left over, I'll just end up throwing them away. I don't need to bring them back home. And this, I actually end up fitting in here. It's gonna be kind of hard to do one-handed. So this, I can either put it in between, that way it doesn't get smashed up against the hard side of the luggage. But I mean, I could either, like I said, I can lay it down, or I can put it standing straight up, and I prefer to do it standing straight up. Okay, so let's do this. We will put these guys on top of this. So those are the shoes. These guys, the souvenirs, a few of the souvenirs that I have, I'll just put them in like so. Okay, so we'll do that in steps. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm gonna take all the items out of the shopping bags and put the shopping bags on the other side of this luggage. So give me a second and I will be with you shortly. Okay, so I just want to show you very quickly. I folded up all the bags. So here's the Louis Vuitton, Liberty, Selfridges, Chanel, Longchamp, Louis Vuitton, and Chanel as well. And as you can see, the Chanel ones have the camellia and the little ribbon as well. So it's really nice that they fold up really nicely. So a lot of people always ask, how do you end up bringing back the bags? This is exactly what I end up doing. I fold everything up as much as I possibly can, because you want to utilize as much space as possible. So now all that I have left, the Primark one, since I have a few goodies in there, it's not really necessary for me to
separate them. That's just gonna go right on top of that there. So as you can see, I have these left over. I have three pairs of shoes, Givenchy, which you guys already saw, my Louis Vuitton box. Okay, so this is probably the question that I get asked the most. This is a very, very large box. A few other times that we have traveled, whenever I do bring back the boxes, I end up putting either my toiletries in here, my shoes in here, and that way it kind of takes up a little bit of space, but, I mean, it helps minimize the space. But the greatest thing about these new Louis Vuitton boxes is that they are collapsible. So let me just show you. Let me take this off. I pretty much, it's like deconstructing a, what's it called? And it's deconstructing and unboxing is what it is. Because you know me, I want to bring everything back. And the young lady at Louis Vuitton at Selfridges, she gave me that ginormous, ginormous dust bag, an extra dust bag. So that was pretty cool. Okay, so now this Louis Vuitton box, there's the bag. We'll take that out. We'll be reunited shortly. Okay, so these new Louis Vuitton boxes, they have these little tabs here. So all you're going to do, you're going to pull on the tabs and they fold in so nicely. So that's what it's going to look like. Then that's what they do. They fold up, which is great. You can't fold them up, you know, three or four times. You just fold them up once or twice, and that's what it folds up into, which is awesome. And check that out. It fits in there, no problem. I still have quite a bit of space. And what I really like about this particular luggage, this is the Delsey Paris, and I'll show you guys it in a second, but it does give you a little bit more extra space, but it's really difficult to show you now, so my apologies, but I'll show you in just a second. So this is the one that I'm going to check in. So the fact that I have the bags and some of the boxes, that doesn't bother me. This is the one that I want to focus on because I want to fit as much of the Luxe goodies as I possibly can into this one, because I've had really bad luck with my main luggage getting lost, and I would really hate to lose any of these items in that, and then what if they end up losing my luggage? You know what I mean? So, all right, so give me 1 second, and let me see if I can situate the the camera a little bit better. So there's the Longchamp, the Givenchy, Louis Vuitton. That's the small good from Louis Vuitton in the small bag. The Chanel, the other Chanel, and then those two were in the Liberty bag. And then the Primark, as I said before. All right, so give me 1 second. Okay, so this is all I did, is I put the Givenchy in my little carry-on. It's not the biggest carry-on, so I ended up putting the larger Louis Vuitton dust bag on the bottom because I want to make sure that the leather doesn't get any crazy indentations from now until the time we arrive in California. And then this is my Louis Vuitton, and it's not folded up. I know if I ended up folding up the bag, I would get a little bit more space, but because of the creasing that these bags get, I want to try to avoid that as much as possible. And I'd have to say that one of the benefits about it being this particular bag is the fact that it is canvas, so I don't have to worry too much about indentations as I do with the Givenchy. Okay, so this is all I'm going to do. I have quite a bit of cover or of clearance on the height of the Louis Vuitton with my luggage. So just to show you, I have enough space there so it won't end up smashing it down or anything like that. So again, the Givenchy, I'm just going to lay it down right on here so you can see a little bit better. I still have quite a bit of clearance. Now, this is where it gets tricky. The Chanel, the small Louis Vuitton good, and the Longchamp are going to go in here. The Longchamp goes in there. The Chanel will just put in here. I ended up unzipping this because I want to make sure I have as much room as possible, because if I did zip this, I wouldn't have as much clearance as I do right now. So this will be loose. We could probably put it in here. I'm gonna mess this up, but I need to bring back the box. Trust me, it would be so much easier if I didn't have to worry about the boxes. Okay, and then here is the ribbon that goes on the Louis Vuitton. So there's that. Okay, so as you can see, I don't have space for these three Chanel, or for these three shoes. So what I ended up doing is I put these flats on top of my heels. I moved these over, and the shirts that I had originally put right here, if you guys remember, I'm actually going to take them off, and I'm gonna put them on this side as well as the gift wrap. The gift wrap is taking up quite a bit of space. So I think what I might end up doing is I'll end up putting my other shoes. Oh, that's gonna get dirty. This is where the Tetris comes in. Let's see if I can figure this out. All right. Hopefully the camera isn't making you guys queasy. I know it's going to end up hitting on there, which is what I want to avoid. Okay, so I did another little dry run to see if this will work. So there are the heels and the flats. Those I'm just going to squish as much as I can there. And the bag of dirty clothing I'm actually going to put right on top. So it still gives me quite a bit of space here for the shoes. So I moved my Vans off the side that I had them over there. And here are the souvenir shirts and what I said, and then the three pairs of shoes that I have left. Okay, so the Valentino will end up going quite nicely there. And I now, just something to note, that if you do end up bringing shoes back and they are on the side of the luggage, just know that they run the risk of getting maybe a little bit smashed, a little bit wrinkled, because I mean, I tend to prefer the hard shell luggage a lot more. I used to have the soft one, and I just found that things would get very wrinkled, very smashed, and it just really wasn't helping out whenever I would bring back items. But these can take a little bit more abuse, but there, I still run the risk that these will end up getting smashed, and we'll end up seeing how it ends up working out when I get home. So I'm also going to show you at the end of this video, hopefully, if everything goes as planned, how it ends up looking. Okay, so here I have the Chanel, the Valentino. Remember, these are getting checked. And I have these left. Okay, so this is where we get into quite the predicament. Okay, so I ended up putting the souvenir shirts here on the top part of the luggage. So it does give me a little bit more of a buffer with the Chanel box and the luggage there, so I don't have to worry too much about this one. But again, there's still a chance that this will end up getting a little bit smashed. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this coat. I'm gonna put my Vans here. The coat will just go right on top. Okay, and remember how I said that if I unzip this on the carry-on, it gives me a little bit more clearance? That's what I was trying to say earlier with that portion there. Because I unzipped it, it gives me a little bit more space on this side. Okay, so here we go. I have one box left. Now this box is going to be a little bit of a pain in the butt. Not gonna lie. I'm getting just a little bit stressed out. okay, so, I think what I'm going to do is all the items that I have here from Primark, I'm actually going to put them in my niece BB, since it's pretty much empty. I'm going to put all those items in there so that way I have a little bit more space. So give me 1 second. Okay, so I took all the items out from the Primark bag and I just laid the bag on here. I know I can throw it away. I know, but we don't have one in the United States, so I'm super stoked that I want to bring that back. Okay. So here is one of the jackets that I got at Primark, and then I'm just going to put these shoes right on top. Okay, so you saw the souvenir shirts. Remember, underneath here I have my Vans, my trench coat, more clothing. I haven't taken anything out. In the Nice BB, it was able to go right back in the same spot, and I have all the other items that I got from Primark in here, which are really just makeup items plus my daily makeup. My dirty clothing. Under here, I have the shoes and then the other pair of ballerina flats. Where are they? Right there. Valentino's, Chanel shoes. Okay, and then these. All right, so that is this. And then I think I might end up just putting this jacket right on top. I'll be able to get away with it. And Robert has his items as well. So he got a few things from Superdry. Now this guy, I'm just gonna leave loose. I don't wanna zip it up again. I wanna leave as much clearance as I possibly can. Okay, although I could zip it up. Let's see how it ends up working out. All right. Okay. So again, there we go. I have enough clearance. I haven't smashed anything down. And let's see if it works, you guys. Bam. There you go. You saw exactly what I have in there. The box, one box, a bunch of bags, a few things from Primark, and three pairs of shoes. That does make me nervous, I'm not going to lie, but the bags are what worry me the most. Especially because it was a Valentino, the Chanel. The Chanels are really the ones that kind of make my heart a little bit more nervous. I'm not going to sit here and say it doesn't. It does. So over here I have the Longchamp. Again, I have the Louis Vuitton. It's not completely smashed. It's not completely folded up as they normally would with these bags. But again, you can see here, which makes it very easy to be able to fold a little bit easier because that's the way that they end up even storing it in the store. Personally, I don't prefer it that way. I prefer them to be, if I had the option, I would prefer it to be completely stuffed while I'm carrying it, but I just have way too many items that I ended up purchasing. Okay, so there's Longchamp was there, and I'm trying to be the most careful with this Givenchy, again, because of the leather, and I wanna make sure that I don't end up, what's it called? I don't end up smashing anything down. Okay, so I'm doing this one-handed, so bear with me. It was able to fold, or it was able to close up very nicely. Again, this is the carry-on. So in here, I have a total of three bags, if you count the Longchamp, the small Louis Vuitton Good, as well as the Chanel, the smaller Chanel box. So this is what I'm gonna take with me on the plane. So there is one. Now this bad boy, I'm not even going to try to move it because it's going to be super heavy. So this is the brand Delsey. It's just a really, really, really great brand for luggage, in my opinion. There's a ton that are out there that are fantastic. Robert actually has an It. So there's his luggage. And they've been working out quite nicely, a lot better, again, in my opinion, than the softer luggage. So there we go. That is it, you guys. You saw absolutely everything. Look, there's nothing. I'm not gonna lie to you. Everything that I showed is in those two suitcases, so I'd say it was pretty good.
All right, so you just saw me pack everything into my carry-on and my luggage, and I'm hoping that I don't forget anything. My makeup is looking like shiza, but it's really late, and it's really hot in here. I'm wearing a long-sleeve shirt, plus making sure that everything kind of fits in. It's a little, it can be a little tedious, but, you know, it's all a matter of you know, I'd have to say that the biggest advice that I can give as far as bringing back luxe goodies is really in what you bring into the country that you're, or the place that you're visiting. I had to sit down, and it might sound a little crazy to some of you, but I really had to sit down and think twice about what clothing I was bringing. You know, I had to ask myself, am I really going to use this? Is this really going to, am I just bringing it just to bring it? And, you know, I think it was, I thought extra hard on this particular trip because of the weather that we were coming into. You know, so I was wearing coats, scarves, jeans, long pants, and trench coats and boots and whatnot. And if we were going to a warmer destination, then I wouldn't have to worry too much because I would have shorts and t-shirts and flip-flops and whatnot. So the fact that I had such thick clothing to bring here, it really takes away from how much I'm able to bring back. But again, I had to think twice about what I'm bringing. You know, I had to say, am I bringing it just to bring it? You know, I have to make sure that whatever I brought is something that I was going to sincerely use. If it makes you feel better bringing more items, absolutely, whatever makes you feel more comfortable, that is really the key. That's really what makes that's the most important thing, you know. But again, I knew what I wanted to buy when I was here. I had an idea, I had a wish list, and I tried to stick to it. I went a little overboard with a few items, you know, but I'm very excited that I did ask myself about the outfits that I was bringing, and now I'm able to bring back some of the other goodies, plus the boxes and the bags, which makes me very, very happy, because I don't know what it, maybe it's the pack rat in me that I have to have those with me. You don't have to. I mean, you could take everything out of the boxes and you're good to go, but it's just, you know, it's one of my quirks. All right. What can I say? I forgot to add one more thing. I still haven't gone through Heathrow, so I might end up picking up a few other items there. I'm going to try to keep blinders on and be good, but you never know. So that doesn't include whatever I end up buying there. And if I do end up buying something, then I'll end up just putting it in Robert's backpack. So I just thought I'd say that, because there might be some other goodies that you might end up seeing that weren't in this video. So just know that. All right, so now I'm rambling. I'm getting completely sidetracked. But I really sincerely hope that this video was helpful. And if you have any other questions, I'll be more than happy to answer them. And if I need to do a follow-up video, I can do that as well. But I just wanted to show you how much I was able to fit into my luggage while still being able to carry my regular items, as well as the bags, the boxes, and whatnot. So thank you guys so, so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already and you would like to, please subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on the red button down below that says subscribe. And again, I hope you found this helpful, and I will see you all when I get back into Cali. And as always, make it a fabulous day or not, the choice is yours. Have a great day, you guys.